Some say masturbation is a curse, a form of weakness, a source of guilt, shame, and confusion. Others call it natural, healthy, and even essential. So which is it? Despite all the opinions, most people don't stop. And that's interesting, because when a behavior is this common across cultures, religions, and even species, it's worth asking, why? Today we'll explore what science actually says about masturbation. Not just whether it's good or bad, but how often is healthy, what it does to your brain and body, and what the evolutionary purpose behind it might be. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, urologist and specialist in sexual health. And if you've ever asked yourself where the urge to masturbate really comes from, science has an answer. I'll reveal it in this video. Science has developed explanatory models for masturbation because it's a fascinating fact across species. However, these models focus on the male side. Of course, women masturbate too, but female masturbation follows different biological patterns and different scientific models. In this video, we'll focus on men, not because women don't matter, but because their biology deserves a separate episode. Scientists now believe that masturbation is more than just a behavioral error. In fact, they now believe it serves a biological purpose. But what kind of purpose would that be? If masturbation really has an evolutionary function, then there must be a competitive advantage. In nature, advantage often means reproduction. So the question is, could masturbation somehow improve a male's chances to pass on his genes? That's exactly what researchers now believe. According to one hypothesis, masturbation might act as a biological preparation, clearing the system, improving sperm quality, or even shortening the time to ejaculation. In a competitive environment, that might be the difference between success and no offspring at all. In another hypothesis, masturbation without ejaculation prior to intercourse speeds up fertilization. This could allow lower-ranked males to reproduce before being displaced, giving them a genetic edge. In the end, masturbation is seen across many species, but only one species knows the concept of sin and culture, the human species. That makes it very special. Animals don't think about masturbation. They just do it. Humans do it, and they assign meaning to it. That's the fundamental difference. Because with this difference, a burning question arises: how often is enough? If this question strikes a chord and this video helped you rethink something you've always felt, then UroChannel might be the place to visit more frequently. If you want more medical insight without moral judgment, this channel is for you. If you like this kind of content, a like, a share, or subscription is a form of digital applause. Free for you, but incredibly helpful for me. It signals me your approval, and it motivates me to continue my mission on YouTube. So, how often should you masturbate according to science? Let's take a closer look at the data and the variables that matter most. For that, we have to separate physical benefits from mental ones. Science has a concise answer when it comes to prostate health. The number is 21. The health professionals' follow-up study showed a 33% reduction in prostate cancer risk if you masturbate 21 or more times per month. Almost 30,000 participants and over 222,000 years of follow-up. That's a powerful foundation for a simple truth. But there's more to masturbation than just prostate health. It also affects the brain. Every time you masturbate, your brain goes through a predictable neurochemical cycle. Dopamine rises, tension is released, and the reward system is activated. That can feel good, even therapeutic, but it also means masturbation can become a coping strategy, especially when life gets stressful, boring, or lonely. Science doesn't give us a fixed number here, but it gives us a clue. If masturbation becomes the main way you deal with emotions, you may be reinforcing a pattern that numbs instead of helps. That's not a moral judgment, it's a neurological observation. Your brain rewires based on what you repeat. If you masturbate occasionally, you're probably fine. If you masturbate excessively, not because of desire, but because of habit or escape, your brain will start to follow that path. And here's where it gets tricky. Culture may say, don't, but the brain says, it works. That's the conflict many men experience. They feel shame about something that's neurologically effective, which makes them do it more and hate themselves more. The result? Guilt, secrecy, and confusion. Science can't solve that, but it can show you how the loop works and give you the tools to step out of it. So, is masturbation good or bad? That's the wrong question, because biology doesn't care about good or bad. It cares about function. And culture doesn't care about biology. It cares about meaning. As a man, you live in between. Between what your body wants and what your world tells you to want. That's not easy. But it's not a flaw either. It's a chance to know yourself more deeply. Not by fighting your urges, but by understanding them. If this video helped you take one step in that direction, then it was worth it.